All right, man. We're back for another week. The podcast.
What up, everyone?
Yeah. We've been gone for a week.
Yeah.
We're back. I mean,
yeah.
You know, sorry for the delay, but we're going to bring you twice as much energy this week as we normally would. But we skipped a week, but now we're back for episode number 2 of the podcast.
Let's get it.
Here with the official Brunch Boys. So before we even start, before I say another word, I just want to say arrest, you know, the killers of Breonna Taylor and the killers of Elijah McClain. Always, as Black Lives Matter. Still now, we never forget. And anybody that's going through things right now, because, you know, we got the pandemic going on. So, you know, people all around the world, from the explosions in Beirut. I be seeing a lot of sex trafficking going on. So, you know, women, ladies, please protect yourselves out there. Protect your kids too. Men, protect your kids. Watch your wives, your girlfriends, you know, your mothers, your sisters, all that. Because it's kind of crazy out here.
It is. That sex trafficking thing is a big business in this.
Big time, big time. Seen that a lot. So, right now on the news. So, you know, protect the females in your lives. So you got to do. And, you know, protect each other. We also want to get into the shout outs because it's a rough time, you know, all the nurses and teachers and stuff taking care of children, taking care of the elderly or anybody that's sick, period. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I'm going to try and thank you every single episode because you guys do a great job keeping us moving, keeping the world moving. Without child, you know, we'd all be in trouble. So thank you.
Yep.
And also shout out to the anybody who does his counselors. Shout out to you too. Because you guys are important. You got to keep the people's mental straight. So I'm not really a believer in counseling, but I know some people need
it. People need it, man. Yeah, people need it.
I have other outlets to get my way out, you know, like things off my mind, but I know people need it. So shout out to the counselors. You guys are needed too. But yeah, welcome to our show. For any new listeners, what we do, we're the official Brunch Boys. And what we do, we go out to eat. We bring you our experiences. You know, with brunch or we're, you know, just going out to eat food wise. We have our Instagram page where we post our pictures. If you guys want to check that out, it's the official Brunch Boys at the official Brunch Boys. If you want to check that out on Instagram, follow us, share it with your friends and family. You got a link to our YouTube from there.
Yeah.
Got a link to our YouTube from there in the bio. So check that out too. You can watch us on there. And if you don't have it, you know, want to watch us on YouTube, if you're on the go. Right now we're on Spotify, and that's the official Brunch Boys. We're on Spotify, so check us out. If you got Spotify, definitely check us out. We're trying to get on Apple, you know, hopefully that happens soon. We're waiting for Apple to get back to us, so hope we get that soon. But you know what I mean? With all that out of the way, might as well start the show, bro. Let's get this.
All right, guys. Look, I need some water to start. You guys ready to order? Or do you guys need more time?
Nah, we're good.
We're good.
All right. So, what can I get you guys?
Bottomless mimosas.
Yeah. Okay. Welcome to the official Brunch Boys podcast. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us today. Thank you for vibing with us. No matter where you at, you know, if you're at work, if you're driving in the car, if you're at home, just woke up. Just appreciate you putting this on. You know, we're going to give you some good vibes, good laughs.
Yep.
Some food shit, you know.
Yep.
Guess we might as well tell them what we're sipping on today. We do mimosas every week, different types. So right now we got the sparkling raspberry mimosas.
That shit tastes fucking good, man.
Yeah, no, that shit is good, though. Yeah. If you want to know, we're going to put pictures up every week of our mimosas and basically the ingredients, so you can make it yourselves. You know, you decide to have brunch or something in the house, you'd be good to do that. But yeah, we sipping on sparkling raspberry mimosas today. It's pretty amazing, gotta say. So, you know,
yep.
But yeah, this week food wise I went to a place called Kraft.
Mm-hmm.
It's like right outside of Philly. It's pretty nice spot. It's the area was it was like a whole bunch of bars going down.
Yeah,
strip bars. It has like a small town vibe, but with a city vibe to it though, because of the bars. It's like bars after bars after bars, and like food places and stuff like that. So that's where I went. I had me what's it called? A smash falafel. That shit.
Smash falafel.
I never even know what a falafel is, but Yeah, it's basically what it is. It's spiced yogurt, cucumbers, cilantro, slaw, and then pickled vegetables. I'm going to throw the picture up, as always.
Yeah,
I'm going to throw the picture up on our
beat?
Nah, I was veggie, bro. Yeah, I'm throwing a picture up on our Instagram, and so y'all can check it out. Y'all can see, you know, exactly what I'm talking about. But yeah, nah, it's good though.
Good,
it's good. Yeah,
and I'm gonna try it.
The food's really good. I had some wings too. Their fries, they had some good fries. But yeah, nah, it was different though, you know. Mm-hmm. And then they put some. It's between two sandwich breads, so it was like a smash falafel with a bun around it. But then they had some more veggies on top of it. It was pretty
good.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I got it.
I mean, looks wise, it had all the looks. And
taste wise,
it was pretty good.
It was good.
Pretty good. It wasn't bad. It wasn't like I'm more with the, you know, eating like shit with meat in it.
Yeah. Pause,
no homo. But I, you know what I mean? Like on my plate, things with the meat in it. So it was you know what I mean? Doing something different.
Okay,
but you know you gotta have wings. I try wings. Wings is my favorite food, so I gotta. I had to try wings, so I tried it out there. But yeah, now that's outside of Philly. It's called Kraft. If anybody want to check it out, I put the picture up on the Instagram. So just check that out, and y'all can see exactly, you know, what I had.
Yeah,
where you went?
I went to Easton, Pennsylvania. If anybody ever go to Pennsylvania, do not go to Easton. It's a very, very boring town, but you know, in boring towns you could find one of the best foods. So I checked out the Bayou, and I had a chicken and waffles. It's like pickled spiked syrup and powdered sugar. You know, it was good with the fries. With the chicken wing, with the fried chicken, all that stuff.
They make the best.
Yeah, well,
they make one of the best fried chicken around.
Yeah, it was pretty good. They do a lot of work, but you know, Easton is a chilled spot. The Bayou is definitely a chilled spot. You know, you can take your friends and family.
Was a comparison because we went to the one the week before. What do you think?
I would take the one in Easton,
yeah,
because
over, you know, the one in Bethlehem?
Yeah, definitely, because I feel like there's more space. Pretty much,
the
space,
the one in Bethlehem is more. See, that's the thing too. Like for people, you know, if you guys decide to go to Bayou, it's the Bethlehem one is more for like if you take a significant other, because it's more intimate.
It's more intimate.
Yep. The one in Easton. Easton's more of a chill one. If you're going out with your friends, it's probably better you go to the Easton one. But if you're going out with, you know, like your significant other, the Bethlehem one has more of like a nice ambiance to it.
Yes, and they give you bottomless mimosas.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So
bottomless mimosas in Easton. Bethlehem is not doing that right now. You know, if you're trying to get some, you know, get fucked up on a Saturday or Sunday, you should definitely go to the Easton one because they do it there. The Bethlehem one has like they shrunk their menu for right now.
So
for anybody trying to get, you know, bottomless mimosas, and I think they do, it's like $15 for the mimosa. You get the big jug, like this one. And I think refill, it's like 25 cents.
Yeah, yeah,
which is crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, we did
it's
that crazy. Before. And we got messed up a little bit on a Sunday. Yeah, we did that, and then went to see the Bad Boys. That was the day Kobe died. We did bottomless mimosas, like four of them.
Oh man,
kept refilling them shits up.
Okay,
but yeah, nah. But you enjoy your food though.
And oh yeah, I definitely did. It was a good experience with the eating. The waitresses were also very nice. You know, they were very respectful. You know, so like,
gotcha.
You know, it's a place to check out. You know, check out their foods. The scenery, is not, you know, that great.
Yeah,
but the food is
the circle. There's not much to look at really. Yeah, now where I went, actually, the scenery is actually one of the best things. There's a big ass river next to.
It's a big ass river.
See, so like, you could go walking. Like if you go there with somebody, you could go walking by the river. It's pretty dope.
Good
scenery wise is real dope. The only thing they didn't allow nobody to eat inside. Everybody was outside. So yeah, it was like outside. Right now it's like the lantern flies. You're killing like 10 of them while you eat.
Oh, they were in Philly too.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere.
Lantern flies are everywhere.
Oh, man.
But they were flying all over the place. But you know what I mean, the outside thing. I enjoyed the outside thing. I hope they keep it going even after everything's done. Definitely. Yeah. Because I enjoy it being outside.
I enjoy it a lot. Yeah.
I mean, even with the flies around and shit, I still enjoy it.
I don't mind flicking one or two.
Killing the bunch is all good. It's a civic duty at this point. So anybody out there, you see lantern fly, kill it. It's all our civic duties to kill these things. It's everybody's responsibility to get rid of them. But I mean, yeah, that's what we got for you for our brunch this week. What we're gonna mostly try to do, you know, going towards the future, is our hopes is that, you know, we get our name up, and then we can actually give you actual brunch from inside these restaurants, which would be dope. So we do like a traveling, we'll do like traveling shows, you know, here and there. Even if it's not every single episode, at least some episodes we do a traveling one, just so we could give you guys the actual experience. I was also thinking we should probably get like a cameraman one of these days, yo.
We could get
like a video and when we go out.
Yeah,
one of these times, so we could give, you know, people like the back. Or we can save that for like later on, release like some.
Like,
there's ideas. We could do that. But yeah, now we're gonna work towards bringing you guys, you know, an episode from inside restaurants. Once we get our name up. So
yeah.
Basically, yeah, you know what I mean? Check out our pictures. We post some really dope pictures, man. I promise you.
Hit the likes too.
You know, hit the likes, like, comment, subscribe. If you're watching this from YouTube, please subscribe.
Hit it like it's retarded.
Like it, and please put your friends and families on. Just put people on. I mean, if you know, let's say you're a last time listener and you're not going to listen to this after, just share it with somebody that you know would enjoy it. Or just share our page, our Instagram page, with somebody you know that enjoys just food pics, because there's a lot of people that do. Or even people that just want ideas of places to go out to eat. Share it, you know, share it, comment, subscribe. You know, we're the Brunch Boys, you know, we're on Twitter, and you can find all our information in our description. We're going to try to get it on the screen for you with some time to come. But as of right now, just, you know, share us, you know, because the best way is, you know, word of mouth. And we really appreciate it. It won't cost you nothing to share it. Absolutely nothing, you know. Mm-hmm. So just please comment, subscribe, you know, like our stuff. We really appreciate it. So let's get into this, man.
Let's get
what we got into
it
today, though.
The Meg and Cardi B, their new.
Yeah, let's start with the biggest topics over the last couple of two weeks.
Yeah.
Everybody been talking about it. It's a Meg and Cardi WAP video. WAP standing for wet ass pussy.
I didn't even know what that stands for. Yeah.
Stands for wet ass pussy. Is some crazy lyrics.
What do you think about that?
The song, it's not bad. Like, song wise,
yeah,
it's vulgar, but I fuck with it. The only thing is, you know, there's no clubs open. Where you going? I'm not gonna listen to that.
People are gonna rock it in their house. This house.
No, party. I hear that. Yeah, girls repeat that. But for dudes, like, that's the thing. Is like, as a dude, I played it and I watched the video.
Yeah,
and I'm not putting it on my playlist. Like,
I just, definitely, you know, not. What I mean,
it's not making it to my
definitely
playlist.
Not.
So it's really something that I saw once. You know, maybe I might hear it here and there, but it's not making it on my playlist. Like,
I was reading the lyrics, bro, and I was like, "What is going on?" So I'm not even gonna read the intro. Let me read a little bit of it.
There's some hoes in this house.
Yeah. So, yeah, you effing with some wet ass.
Yeah, son.
P word.
That's how they wet ass pussy, yo.
Bring a bucket and a mop for these wet ass
pussies, yo.
P word.
Yeah, come on, man. They got nasty right
Give
now.
Give me everything you got for these wet ass.
I like that. The thing I like about it, they didn't waste no time. Like, I like that. Like, you come straight in. They didn't waste no time. They just got straight to the nastiness.
I know, but like, my thing is, people are listening to it.
Yeah.
And what the influence? That's what I gotta hammer on. The influence. Because
it's
like,
song, you gotta,
because it's a song,
of songs.
And we got like teenagers listening to stuff like this.
Oh, not good.
Come on, bro. I gotta say that because
you sound like what? A parent.
Okay, I sound like we're
old man.
We're talking. No. We're talking about you know, morality here.
Music is expression. Right?
Expression of what? So
it's
she's
art.
Expressing
how wet the pussy is.
How wet the pussy is?
Yeah. It's expression. Music is art.
Okay.
Right? Art is expressive.
It's expressive.
Okay,
but I get it. But a 15-year-old is going to be expressing out right, wet so, her.
No. All right. That's the thing, too, out here, right? Some girl I saw on Twitter, because I'm active on Twitter. This girl was like, she tweeted, ladies, are we going to put WAP in our bios, right?
Yeah.
So I was like, nah. Like, I went and replied. I was like, nah. Some of these girls are going to put, SAP, SAP, right?
What is that?
You got it? Stink ass pussy.
Oh.
Like, some of these girls, they're going to put that. Some are going to put that. Dry ass pussy, like, you know what I mean? This video, all it's gonna do is encourage the girls that they don't have no wet pussy. Like, they just gonna make every girl think that they got that shit. But all is, it's not. It's music is expressive. It's not no, like, you know, this is like almost saying kind of like Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
Do you want your kids to play Grand Theft Auto?
You can't stop. You can't stop kids from listening to this kind of music.
All right then. So why
can't
they make it?
You can stop a kid from playing a Grand Theft Auto, but listening to music is different.
When you're not home,
like, what is sneaking the games under their beds and stuff?
What do you mean?
But
yeah,
but it's different though.
How's it different?
A game is different from a music that is mainstream.
How's it different?
That you can easily access off YouTube.
So what about like a rapper about, you know, killing people and stuff?
Yeah, that too. I'm for that. Like, what the fuck are you rapping about?
Censoring this shit. So you?
I mean, I don't have the power to do it, but if I had the power to do it, get the fuck out of here. You were getting censored. If it was my world, you were getting censored.
You bugging, bro.
Because I don't want women expressing their feminine side.
I do express
when it comes to the pussy,
ladies.
The hell,
express it. Let it out. If you got that WAP, express it. If you don't.
Then express it. You're a whore. You're a whore.
Oh, you bugging. Hey,
like, unless you're expressing it to your man,
nah,
you're a whore.
Wild. You sound wild.
Why is that wild?
You sound wild. You sound wild.
All right.
You sound wild. What if they express that on OnlyFans? Express it. I want to see you express it. Express it on the cam so I can see it. You know what I mean? Like,
oh, man.
Express yourself. I'm all about expression. As long as it's not hurt. Like, if you're not hurting nobody, express yourself. Like, if you want to put in your bio that you got WAP, and if you really got WAP, you got WAP. Express yourself. It's all good.
I think that should be private.
I mean, if you got kids, or I'll say it, parents, watch your kids. Don't be playing this in the house around your kids, and that's it.
The kids are going to access it regardless
of their
parents.
They home right now.
It's on YouTube, bro.
Nah, they'll be all right.
The
video, see, that's the thing, too.
You're going to see a lot of girls twerk.
I wish it was like back in the day. Remember back in the day when the BT had the uncut?
Yeah, I remember
that. If this was back in the day,
yeah,
that WAP video would be crazy.
It would be crazy.
It would be a crazy
video. It would be crazy.
The video and the video now and the song, to me, they don't really go, because I thought they would be like almost half naked and shit.
Nah,
like,
it's mainstream.
Yeah, it wasn't really like, I thought they would have like pasties on their boobs. Like,
nah, but
you know, like, I mean, something crazy.
This age is different in the sense that, you know, because it's so like, it's so accessible, and the words, if you listen to the words and the beat,
it's the common shit.
So like most women, young girls, maybe some men will express it. How there'll be a dance to that. They were twerking. If it's twerking or something like
ladies,
that, I don't know.
Ladies, I'm all with it. Express yourself.
I don't know. Like, I just think it's a little weird, bro. I think the lyrics are ridiculous. Like,
yeah, that, but I think a lot of people are gonna listen to it. It doesn't match the video, like how raunchy the lyrics are.
Oh yeah,
the video is not as raunchy as the lyrics, but if it was like back in the day BET uncut, that would have been some real,
it would have been
real
some
ass video. It would have been crazy.
Yeah, it would have been
I kind of wish it was back then so I could see what they do with it.
Like,
I'm all about self-expression. Express yourselves. Yeah, don't let nobody like Nick tell you that not to express yourself.
Not to express yourself. You could express yourself, but you don't have to, like, you know, express your WAP to me. I don't want that.
They just saying
that. There are men that don't want that. It's not just me.
All right, so
there are men out there that don't want that.
Those guys are, those kind of girls are not their type, and those kind of men are not those kind of girls.
But what is he portraying? Like, you know, what is he portraying? Like,
self-expression.
Because you don't want. You don't want a man to be looking at you, but like, you know, I wonder if she got some WAP. I bet.
Wait, so when you meet a...
I don't want that to be the first stop.
Hold on.
Like, you know?
So when you meet a girl and she looks dope, you don't be like, yo, I want
what?
You don't wonder like, damn, I wonder how that shit is.
Nah, man. No. Wait. I'm not. No.
You're lying to the people right now, bro.
Hold on. I'm not lying. Hold on.
Don't believe you.
I don't think that.
You don't think what?
I don't think that thought actually doesn't come to my mind. I wonder if her shit is good. No, you don't know if her shit is good until you actually try it.
Yeah, but what if?
But you don't think? I don't think, like, you know. Oh, I wonder if that's if.
Her shit is good. What if when you get to that level, then it's not good.
Then it's not good.
But then what if?
Then she got some. I don't want that to be the first thought, though.
It doesn't have to be the first.
It seems that's the first thought for you, bro.
For me,
because you said that
is the attraction. Nah,
yeah, yeah.
Okay, so what we go by? Like when you see is by look. You okay. See somebody like, oh, they're attractive. I'm gonna approach her.
But I'm not saying that. Oh, I hope she got some WAP.
You
can't say that until you try it.
No. When you're in the midst of talking, getting to know the person, right?
Yeah.
Or even let's take it back just to the basic. You met her at the club or something, or the bar.
Now, let's say
you take a girl back home.
Yeah.
That is the first thing on your mind. And in a club or bar, if you are expecting to take somebody home.
Yeah.
That's the first thing on your mind. That's the only thing on your mind is, I wonder how this pussy is, right?
Nah, it was more like, wait. It's more like,
how?
I hope it's good, but it's not. It's not like I hope it's good or I can't wait to hit it.
Nah, I'd be like,
yo, until you hit it, then you can say, oh, nah, it was good or it was whack.
Like a waterfall coming out at
you. Then you're setting yourself up for like some failure.
I'm not putting expectations on it. I'm just saying, hopefully you hope for that. You don't go in there and be like, you know what I mean? This is dry.
I don't hope for anything. I just tried. If it's good, if it's not good, I'm not calling you back.
Nah.
That's what it is.
Nah, yo.
Girls do the same thing too. I don't want to speak for every woman out there, but I'm just saying, girls don't know until they see it.
Nah, they try to touch it.
But they don't know until they see it. They're not gonna
if you're in a club, they try to touch it, bro. They sense it. They can feel it. They feel on their butt. They feel on their butt. Like if they really try to touch you on me, like they can feel it. They know what's up.
So that means if you're dancing with a girl, you're hard or you're why I mean, you're dancing.
Really, it depends if you're really into it.
If you're really into her or into it.
Yeah, I mean, like you're not hard on every dance.
Nah, I'm definitely
like,
not.
If you get the girl that you like, yo, this the one. Come on, so you might be a little bit into it. You might just wind your waist a little bit more than normal because she's over there doing a little aggressively. You know what I mean? Okay. It might get you excited and shit. Okay. Y'all looking at each other and shit. Boom. Might get crazy. And then all of a sudden,
that's not my first thought, bro.
All of a sudden, that moment you got it,
mm-hmm.
Your meat's between her cheeks. Yeah, I mean,
but that's not my thought. Like, you know,
I hear you, but I was saying if you was planning on taking her home or you're,
mm-hmm,
you know,
mm-hmm,
you spending night at her house or she's coming to yours, da da da.
Yeah.
Come on, yo. I hope she got some good shit. That's the thought in the mind. I hope her shit's good. The same way she'd be like, I hope he can fuck. Cause that's what they would say. I hope he can fuck.
Huh. All right. Maybe I've been out that game for a while.
I'm speaking for all women.
But I'm just saying, I don't think it ever crossed my mind until like either I tried it.
For me, it'd be,
and it was, and I tried it was not.
You hope it's WAP every time.
Yeah.
If it's not WAP,
I guess so.
I don't want none.
But hey,
expectations. Now, but like some funny shit,
mm-hmm,
about that video, right? I was on Twitter and this girl, she tweeted. I thought this was hilarious.
Yeah.
People got so mad. She went viral though. But she said, thank God for Cardi and Meg.
Yeah.
Because Beyonce keep giving us Mufasa jams and I'm over it. Yo, I died. I was laughing so hard.
Yo.
But then I went on there and there's two different groups of people that's mad.
Oh, yeah.
The Beyonce fans were mad.
Yeah.
And then the Africans were mad.
You don't fuck with the Queen Bee.
Yeah, but the Africans were twice as mad too because they were like, yo, you calling Afro beats Mufasa vibes. And I'm African. And I was like, that shit was funny.
That shit was hilarious. That shit was hilarious.
That was just a good ass joke. But people were mad as hell. They were going in. And, like, yo, I really don't give a fuck what y'all think.
Okay, it's good that you said that. You brought that. Let me just say this. I don't like the way Beyonce is portraying Africa. I'm gonna leave it at that.
Oh no, I got some
like Africa. Well, the videos that she's bringing out there, that's not the representation of Africa.
Yeah,
It's not Lion King.
Real quick, on her shit, because I watched the whole thing. My takeaway is it felt too overproduced. A couple of the songs were pretty dope. I probably like two of them,
mm-hmm.
but they were like super overproduced to me. I felt like she just doing too much production. It was so much production, bro. It was overproduced. She should have dumbed it down a little bit. It just looked like way too much money was put into it. You know what I'm saying? You're doing a video on Africa.
But Africa is no Wakanda, bro.
I know.
It's not.
But it was really overproduced.
Yourself off that fantasy.
Yeah.
That's
my takeaway. It was good, though.
You know Black Panther.
It just wasn't. It wasn't for me. That's my own.
Definitely not.
It wasn't for me. And, you know, that's not against no, you know, Beyonce fans and shit.
I know that.
It wasn't for me. And I'm African and I was watching I just don't.
I'm sorry.
You know what I mean?
I'm sorry. It's, I'm not throwing any shots to any fans out there, but I'm just saying, like, you know, that's not a portrayal of Africa.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, she
went to different countries and shit, but that's what I'm saying. I felt it was too produced because it didn't come off as, you know, more of a natural kind of thing.
It's not original, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah, they were saying that. They said, like, some parts she stole from, like, Solange and shit.
Yeah, like so it's not original.
Beyonce fans, don't come at me. Yo, I'm good.
Man, you could come at me all you want.
I'm good on this one. I don't want to go against that army.
Because some of the things you try to portray was from my country. I'm from Nigeria.
Yeah, I know. I see.
So come at me, because you don't know
them Africans a clue. Mad.
Yeah, you have no idea. So come at me.
Africans was mad about the Mufasa vibes. Yeah, I thought
that shit was hilarious though. That was funny.
Like I'm African. I'm in there. Like what are y'all mad about? She just made a joke. It's a joke.
It was a joke.
Take the joke.
It was a joke.
Mufasa vibes. That's funny as shit. You know what I mean? Afro beats Mufasa vibes. That's funny, man. But they took it. They took it real, real serious though. When it comes to WAP video, the video is not that great. I'm probably not gonna go back to that song. Uh-huh. But it was a good one time watch. You know. One time listen.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean, fuck with it, you know.
I don't.
And ladies, if you playing that in your crib and you twerking, put it online. You know what I mean? Give us the vibes. Let me get your vibe though. Throw it online. Throw that twerk video online.
Oh man.
I don't mind it. I'll take it. I watch it. Probably not never watch it again, but I'll watch it one time. But yeah, and I mean let's switch it up. Let's get into you trying to get into this women maintaining men. You
know? Yeah, yeah.
And what aspect though, like All right, so ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about basically ladies maintaining men or mm-hmm. being a breadwinner. Is what you
basically being the breadwinner.
So was it for like a guy lost his job?
Like a guy lost his job or a deadbeat in the house, you know, like
or if you got all right, because this shit could go different ways.
Yeah, there's dynamics to this, yeah.
Because if we're just gonna stick to the, you know, you and your man working.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies, if you and your man working, both working, and then he loses a job,
mm-hmm.
and then he's having a hard time finding a job.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that what we're gonna stick with, or are we gonna go into the part where, you know, a girl got with a dude and he's a deadbeat?
I think we should, because there is no one type of man. There's different type of men, you know. So we should,
and different types of situations.
There's different type of situations too, but let's hit it, and we can, you know, I guess dissect it a little bit, you know. We could start with a couple, like the man loses his job and he's having a hard time finding a job. Let's say like in this COVID-19 times, like, you know, a lot of unemployment.
Yeah. If he's unessential.
Yeah.
If you're unessential, what you should be working on is finding either a job that's essential when everything opens back up or creating your own shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's definitely, what I encourage people to do is find different routes to get money to coming in. Just in case anything like this ever happens again.
Yeah.
At least you have different ways to get money while this whole thing's going on. What is going to be sad is when everything does open up and people come out of it
mm-hmm.
and in the same spot that they went in.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
So, but yeah, let's get into the topic though.
All right. So should women maintain their man, you know, in the home? So with a couple that, you know, the man loses his job, my philosophy, you have 4 months to do something with your life. If you're not, then, you know, ladies, stop thinking of a plan B.
Damn, like 4 months?
4 months. That's my
limit. That's reasonable. No. See, 4 months. I say six.
6 months,
that's
bro.
That's when unemployment runs out. I mean, depending if he's going to be unemployment.
Like, you know, is he getting the employment and not looking for a job?
I've known some people who do that. They wait until the unemployment is about to run out and then they get find a new job.
That's trash.
I'm just saying, I know people that have done it.
I know, yeah. But I'm saying that's trash. Like, yeah. You should be looking for a job. Even if, that's why I say 4 months. Let's say you want to chill, you could chill for a month or two, but actively be looking for a job.
Yeah.
You know.
But are we talking about if the unemployment is not coming in? Because it's different dynamics.
If the unemployment is not coming in, you better start, you know, being out there doing something, looking for something, you know, improving yourself, like, you know. Because you want to be functional.
Yeah.
As a man, you want to be functional, and you want, you know, some couples, they struggle a lot because there's no money coming in.
Yeah.
You know, money doesn't bring happiness, but it makes life a little easier.
No, it does. It makes life a little easier. And it also, like, from my experiences, like, you know, it also puts you at the same level as the other person.
You don't get disrespected.
When you don't get disrespected.
Yes.
Where it's like, they don't talk down on you or, you know.
And women will disrespect you if you're not bringing money in the house.
Even if it's in small ways.
Yeah. Like, I don't care. You love your man.
Yeah. It doesn't matter how, because sooner or later, as some time passes, that's what, fellas, you need to understand is, like, as some time passes, her friends are going to ask, or she's going to, you know.
Yeah. She's going to be complaining. Yeah. She's going to.
Her friends and family and complain about it. Yep. Blah, blah. People going to be talking shit. Cause I've been through that experience when I was way younger, where it was like, you know, family's talking crazy.
Start questioning your masculinity and stuff
start
like
questioning
that.
Your relationship.
Yep,
your relationship. Where they're putting ideas in your girl's head.
I totally understand,
and then,
bro.
Now it's like, you're fighting that.
Yes, yes.
You know what I mean?
Like, it's the emotional toll, like, it can take on you, like, you know.
Even if your girl's sitting in your face like, oh, I don't give a fuck what they say, blah, blah. Nah, an idea, small as it is, over time it'll grow.
It does.
And I mean, I agree with the month, a couple months there. I'll probably say six, because that's when unemployment runs out, but
four.
I think automatically you should, if you lose your job in that same situation, it's not bad if, you know, the girl has to handle the things for a couple months.
Definitely.
But if you have the means, there's the thing too. Mm-hmm. For the people who do have the means and the ends to go and get it, if you're just a guy who can go get it, but you choose not to, or you giving excuses not to, then the chick could be out that same month. I'll give you out 2 months. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'll cut that shit down. I'll give you two. You get 2 months.
Yeah.
Because if you have the means and the ends, she should be seeing you every single day.
Yes.
Going out or putting applications out.
Yes.
You like, when she comes home, hey, babe, what you done today? Yo, I came to the crib, I cook. But also, you know what I mean? I put out these applications.
Yes.
And this and that.
Yes.
Like, she got to be seeing that shit every day.
Yeah.
You got 2 months. If you got the means, you got to be doing something. If you're going to chill, if y'all both agree, like, okay, yo, just chill with the unemployment.
Yeah.
You know, let's say you got kids and you be like, you know what?
Yeah.
Let me help out for 6 months.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm gonna get this job.
Yeah,
blah blah. Like, if that type of situations is different.
Mm-hmm.
But if you just have the means and you're able to just go get a new job right away.
Yeah.
And there's nothing standing in your way or anything.
Nothing.
Bro, come on, man.
Yeah.
You got two months. Three if she's feeling lucky. You know what I'm saying? She's in a good mood.
She's in a good mood. Yeah. And like one thing, you don't wanna, like, you don't, like, at first. I know when, mostly if, you know, it was a loving relationship and a dude loses his job or stuff, at first, of course, women, their nature is to care and all that stuff. And that's one thing that is beautiful about them. Like, and women are actually strong in those situations where they can hold their family down.
Yeah, men start cheating. Not black men, but you know what I mean? Black men don't cheat. We're gonna hold on to that one. But like men, some men will get, men take a different route with that. Like women will care for you and it will take care of you. Men on the other hand will, I don't know, like they'll take a completely different route than a woman.
What do you mean? Like if a woman lost their job?
If she lost her job and let's say she wasn't actively looking.
Oh man.
And that man is actively looking.
Yeah.
Y'all know what I mean.
Okay.
He's not actively looking, then he's actively looking.
Yeah.
Not black men though. Because black men don't cheat. But all other kinds of races, they actively looking out here. But you know, for women they start, like I said, it's levels though. It's like the beginning is the caring.
It's the caring, yeah.
And then it's the friends and family talking.
Then it's like
putting ideas in the head.
She start looking at you like,
what the fuck is he doing? Why is he not doing this?
Why is he not doing?
But then she's defending him like, no, but he's cooking and cleaning in the house and da 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 da, this and that. Defending him. Why your friends and family is talking shit over time? That's gonna wear you down.
It's gonna wear. Yeah.
It's gonna wear her down, and then that's when
she start asking questions like, why are you not doing today? Yeah. What are you doing? Like you know, you don't want her to be like, you know, I pay the bills and everything.
Exactly.
Like,
imagine that.
You know, you can't
get that.
You can't do that.
Get there in that situation as a man. I mean, to me, as a dude who's capable, I just, if I'm able to go get a job, I don't see why I wouldn't.
Yeah.
I couldn't just sit at home and just not do nothing with myself. And that's just me. There's some people out there that could though, but then at the same time we're talking, there's some women that might be like, oh nah, I just want my guy to stay home. How about, because there's situations where they have, you know, kids and it's like, oh nah, the dude is going to be the one to stay home because she has the better job. See, in that type of situation,
I would like to say, for that man, find yourself a job.
Yeah.
Find yourself a job, because like,
even if it's from home, like
if you're
doing some shit, do a job from home where you could, if you decide to stay home because the woman has the better job.
Yeah.
And you know, she's gonna go to work while you take care of the kids.
Yeah.
Find a job you could do from home, because then at least you're still doing something where, you know, you have your peace of mind.
Yep.
She has her peace of mind.
Yeah.
Where that kind of situation is not an issue.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Imagine going to your woman, hey honey, give me $100 over here. Give me $100 to fill my gas up. He don't want to do that.
You know? Like, yo, let me get the card though.
Yeah, let me, yeah, you know, stuff like that. Like and that's one thing, like, you know, I know we're in a new generation, but back in the olden days, or days of old, the men were the hunters, right? The women were the keeper of the house. You know, I know their dynamics now where the men,
like, even when you go to other countries and shit, like, you know, where we're from is mostly the guy, the women, the men work, and
yes, you know,
the women,
yeah, the women stay home and
that's our culture. But I mean, like, we have a blended, because we came from that,
yeah,
and then we're here in America where we have blended of two cultures.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm the type where it's, you know, if we're gonna do this shit, let's do it 50-50. We build something together. But at the same time, you know, I would want, like, my girl, I'm single, but you know, I would want my girl to have her own, and also have my own,
because
it's just in case something happens, yo, like, you want to any relationship, you want to be together forever, you want everything to blah blah blah, but things happen.
Things don't happen.
Be delusional, like, if you, unless you're young and you're in high school and shit, you think you're gonna be with somebody forever, but in reality, don't be delusional. Anything could happen.
Anything could happen. I agree.
I believe, we might, let's say we have a joint bank account, but you should also have your own and I'll have my own.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
Because if anything happens, at least one of us is not going to feel bad that the other one doesn't have nowhere to go.
If something happens, I totally understand.
Go get yourself your own apartment, or I'll be out, go get my own apartment. Like, if something happens where we don't end up staying together, at least we can easily walk. My whole thing is, what I try to do is make sure you have enough rent. I mean, enough money in your bank account to pay your rent for a year, just in case you lose your job.
So you have
a year to actually do that shit. I mean, I just living by myself.
Yeah.
When you're with somebody, it's a little easier because you don't have to do all that. But even you, I would still go into that same mentality with a relationship where it was like, I will make sure I have enough money for to pay off our rent for a full year in my bank account.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because that, if just in case, because you, that's what your life, you always, you want to have more money just in case.
Just
you have
in case.
Cards that are open just in case.
Yes.
You have, you know, money backed up just in case anything happens. Your car breaks down or something stupid like that. Mm-hmm. You should always have money just in case some shit happens. So you should always have money just in case you lose your job because shit happens. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, shit.
If I make a mistake, you might fall asleep at work and get your ass fired. You know what I mean? You never know.
You might breathe wrong and get your ass fired.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Right now, you might not wear a mask to work and you could get your ass fired. So it's like, you know, you should always prepare. Yeah, you shouldn't be thinking about, but what if you're saying we're not going to last forever? Nah, yo, you're not childish no more. Nah, you're grown. Things happen.
Yeah,
things happen. You know what I mean?
Things do happen.
So to me, is you should prepare, and it should be something where you both have your own. You come together and you build a foundation.
Yes,
and that's what happens.
That's why I will always put the onus on the men. Make sure that you are functioning. You know, we don't want mama's boys around here.
Yo, never mind.
we don't want mama's boys around here. Like, you know, you should be on your 2 feet, 10 toes, doing what you got to do as a man, because you want to be functioning. The worst thing is for a woman to maintain a man. I think she can do it for a few months, but at some point,
the mental toll, bro.
Yeah, it's starts to shift.
The emotional. Because,
it's the emotional. And women are equipped to, like, you know, like, and women will be there. They will support you. Yeah. But they don't have, I don't feel like they have that emotional, that mental, that capability that's already in a man to be able to be the breadwinner.
Yeah, to be the breadwinner.
Yeah, like, you know.
Go out and go get it.
Yes, all that stuff. Yeah. Like, you know, a woman will support you. Like, you know, if you're a man that is functioning, even if you have a bad day out there and you talk to her and all that stuff, she can console you. She can be like, you know, hey, you know, it's okay. It's going to be fine.
Yeah.
But, you know, if she's not seeing that from you and you're the one, you know, telling, I know it's good to tell your, you know, significant other, like, you know, everything is good. But if you're not supporting her, because, like, imagine if you have a wife that is a breadwinner and she's out there working, let's say a boss or something was hitting on her, and then she knows a boss got money and she's looking at a deadbeat fuckboy husband playing some PlayStation in the house.
Yeah.
Before you know it, she'd be giving that WAP to him. Right?
My whole thing, you know, with that is, like, if it was me in that situation, make sure I don't find out. You know what I mean? Because that'll be everybody in the office.
Then be functional. Be functional.
I always said, like, if I was, because I had this conversation like a couple weeks ago with somebody, and it was like, the minute you put the ring on that finger, man, it changes the whole dynamic.
Oh, no, it does. Like, it does.
If you go out and do some wild shit,
don't.
You should look that man in the face and ask him, like, is he ready to die for that pussy? Like, is it worth it?
It's not.
For him, if it's not worth it, then he should leave it alone, because then.
Yeah. Yeah,
him and his whole family get shot up.
No, like it's like you must, like,
you put the ring on the finger, it's different. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's completely.
I believe you're
getting into some shit. That's why I always tell, like, people, like, you shouldn't mess with a married couple.
No,
I mean, when somebody's married, you shouldn't try to fuck that up, because you never know how that dude is gonna react.
Yep,
as that different mentality.
Or the woman. Yeah.
You never know how that person is going to react. Like, that the mentality that they have when you're actually building something, you got kids together.
Yeah.
It changes a person's mind to where it's like, all right, yo, now you this is my life right now. And you're trying to fuck it up.
You're trying to fuck it up. So, like,
there's so many stories of people just they go out and kill people because like, yo, you fuck my wife. Now you're dead.
Yeah. Like,
you know what I mean?
I will hit it from a spiritual sense in a little bit. When you get married, and, you know, cause you're, you know, you have to say your vows and all that stuff, you're saying it to God.
Yeah.
Cause I know you're saying to that person, you're sincere, but I believe God is listening and that bond is there. You've locked it now. Now, if a man decides to step out or the woman decides to step out, guess what? That covering that you had is broken. Now you're letting all these demons come in there. All this shit. Now your family could be split.
Yeah.
Now everything, every blessing that you could have had in that marriage is fucking gone because like you decided to be an idiot. Because you decided to open your covering to other forces to come in there. That's the way I look at it. But like when it comes to married couple, do not
touch that.
Yeah, yo, that's
like,
a difference.
There's some men out there that's what they love to. Yeah, nah, they do. Women out there, to break a, those are just fucking demons to me.
Nah, but run away from that shit. I know some women that do that. They do it because it's like they know that person got things to lose. They're not gonna get attached, type shit. They like the detachment of it.
Yeah,
it's like that married man will not get attached to her. You know what I mean?
So they do it.
I'm not speaking for all women here. But I mean, speaking from what I know,
yeah,
is the detachment of it, like that man can't get attached to her.
To her, okay, anyway, okay.
As in a different, you know, any.
So the woman is like what a concubine.
I don't want to put no names on it.
No, because there's some cultures that allow that.
No, I know. But I'm not putting no name on it because I have no idea.
No, I'm just saying there's some cultures that allow that. And I mean, all right. For example, let's go to Muslim
country. Hold on. Side note. Before you get there, I got, because you were talking about how the man and his wife and shit. All right. So let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
I saw this on Twitter, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It was a video of let's say you was driving. You went to pick up your girl.
Yeah.
And your mom was with you.
Yes.
And your mom's in the front seat.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
How would you feel if your girl told her to tell your mom to get in the back seat so she can sit in the front?
I would hope she would never get to that level.
So would you have your girl sit in the back?
Because your wife,
let's say,
yes,
different.
Yes.
All right. So out of respect. Yeah.
Out of respect, she should sit in the back.
Your wife
should sit in the back. Because this is where I see it, you know, because when you marry into my family, that has also become your mother. Would you tell your mother to sit in the back?
What if she said yeah?
She said yeah.
So
but if she says no, you respect her and go to the back.
But if she would tell her mother to go to the back for you, or whatever. Or
no,
dad,
no, no.
What if she would tell her dad to go to the back for you?
I'd be like, honey, don't do that. Sir, I'm sorry, stay in the front. That's just the way I am, yeah, though. That's the way I am.
Nah, like, I saw the girl was arguing with the mom, telling her to get in the back. And she was telling her husband, like, yo, you need to tell your mom. you need to tell your mom to get in the back.
You know, he's not getting none for a long, long time.
Yeah. That situation, I looked at, I was like, no, man, because I read some people's reactions. Some people were like, yo, the mom should get in the back. Like, some people really were saying that. They were like, the mom should get in the back seat because him getting married is him starting his own family.
I understand.
And that's
that.
His wife now. So like that's, he has a detachment from his mother. Like his wife is his priority.
But like, you know what I'm saying? Like one thing women,
where we come from is more respect your elders no matter what.
You gotta respect, and you're married into the family. Yeah. And like, you know,
that's where I drew from, where it's like it would be a respect for the elder automatically because that's where how we're raised, is just respect your elders.
You have to, and you, that's the thing. Like most, I know that, and I blame it, and I always blame it on the men, because that man should have set that precedent in the first time. Yeah. Because I know mothers will always love their son, and no women out there can ever stop the love that the mother would have for his son.
Yeah, some women try to separate dudes from their moms and shit.
Like if it's a mama's boy,
that's evil, ladies.
If it's a mama's boy. Yeah, because that's a little weird. But if it's a man that knows where he stands, where he knows where he stands with the mother, and when he stands with the woman, and there's no back and forth, he knows how to, you know, if the mother's acting up, hey, come the fuck down.
Down there.
You're talking to a man. You're not talking to a little boy anymore. Gotcha. And if it's the wife is like, hey, that's my mother. The reason why, you know, you think I'm this man I am now, she was part of it. So like, you know, you got to respect her. If you respect me, respect her. And you're married to this family.
Right. Now,
so, you know, like that's what it is.
Like that's how I view it too. But then I also understood from the point where people were like, you know, he started his own family. Like,
I get it.
That's the woman of his household now. Yeah. So that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. It was a car situation, bro. It's not like
No, I know, but it was to you, like, it might be a car situation, but like us, like certain situations, we're dudes. So it's like certain situation is pride shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think in that situation, she wanted to let the mother know, like, yo,
that's me now.
Women try to take that role,
but you can never take a role of a mother.
Like, I would view it the same way you are, just because of how we grew up.
Yeah.
But I also understand that side of it, though.
I don't.
I do. I understand that side because it's like, yo, I have my own family. Like, yes. Not in no disrespect, because the video she was disrespecting. But
yeah.
If let's say, you know, your girl got in the backseat, but then later she was like, you know, I would appreciate if that ever happened next time. Like, I want to be in the front seat. Like, if she just brought it up, like, not to your mother, but to you as in conversation, where I would understand it, because it's just, this is my family. Like, yeah. This is me now. You know what I'm saying? Like,
okay.
And to me, I understand that. But at the same time,
I could understand where you're coming from in that. And you know, and the man should take some kind of, you know, I guess be smart before you pick.
Because if it was in reverse, let's say, you know, you and your girl went to go pick up your mom.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is your girl leaving the front seat to go sit in the back?
Fuck no.
Exactly.
Yeah. No. She's not. And my mom will not tell her, hey, go to the back. It's not happening.
That's what I'm saying. But it depends on the situation.
Yeah. But the that's why I say the man should be like, you know, mom, can you sit in the back?
Yeah.
And no mom, trust me, no mom will argue that. No mom would argue like, no, the fuck you mean? Sitting back? Like, I birthed.
You're wrong. There's some moms out there who they some mom, their son intensely.
Keep her in the house.
Yeah.
Let her stay in the house.
But that was the quick aside, though. I said that shit. I was like, all right, it might come in with this topic. So I wanted to see where your mind was at. But, you know, I mean, we're on the same page with that. I agree. Because how we grew up, man, it's always respect your elders first. You know
respect your elders. And, like, there's a role of a mother, there's a role of a wife, and there's a role of you as a son and a husband. Play your roles. Don't disrespect. A wife should not be trying to act like she birthed me.
Some situation, that line is super fine. You just gotta learn how to walk through that.
You just gotta learn how to work. And I will always put it on the man, because it's like, you know, even if you're a son and you grew up to be a man, you should be wise.
Yeah.
You know, like, you could put your mother in her place.
Yeah, if she disrespects.
If she disrespects, put her in her place.
Yeah, for sure.
And your wife also. And your wife has to see that, so you know that this dude don't play no games.
Don't play around.
You know,
shit.
So that's the way I put it. Like, in that situation, I saw the video too. The dude didn't even know what to do.
He didn't know what to do. He was just like,
he looked like a mama's boy to me.
His wife is going off.
Yeah.
And his mom is like just sitting there and shit, like, she's not getting out. Like, bro, you're gonna have to call a Uber or something for your girl.
Imagine that.
In that situation, I'll be like, yo, you go drive, I'm in the back seat.
Word. See if you see you want to be in the front so bad.
You want me in the front so bad? Yo, you drive, I'll be in the back seat. Fuck that. But she was disrespecting the mom, though. And that's the one part I took out the video. I was like, yo, like, that's OD disrespect.
The way
she was talking to the mom.
Yeah.
As a dude, I would have to check her. Like, yo, no. Don't ever talk to my mom like that. I know you're my wife and shit, but that's a woman that birthed me, like, took care of me, blah, blah, blah. Respect her the same way.
The reason why you see me as a man that you want to be that you want to be with today and have kids with.
Because she was
part of it.
Yeah,
you know?
She bugged out. But damn, I forget what was that one. Was
the maintaining of the other,
But I forget what part of it though we were. But you want to keep going with it?
Let's keep going. Let's keep going.
You want to switch it around? We could jump into a different topic.
Yeah.
Completely different topic. Let's go with football, man.
Football.
Right now we got college football. They got, was it the Pac-12?
Yeah.
And then a big, damn, do I have it backwards or?
It's Pac-10.
It's Pac-10, right? It's Big Ten. It's Big Ten and Pac-12. I knew I had that shit right.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Big Ten and Pac-12, they're pushing their season back.
The season
to
back.
The spring next year because of Corona.
I don't know.
But the rest of the league is going though.
It's going, yeah. I don't know why they're doing that.
But those
kids,
they're saying they still got to go to class, which is crazy.
Yeah, of course.
I don't understand it. But in college, like, the rooms are bigger and shit. So
you
can be separated from.
Are they fucking up potential NFL prospects from those?
Who gives a fuck? Them kids ain't getting paid. They shouldn't play. That's how I feel about it. Now, the ones that are, it's a small amount of kids that go to the league.
It is.
So for those kids, you know, they've already seen your tape. They're going to take you regardless. It doesn't even matter. But
okay.
For my thing is the kids that are not, majority of those kids are not going to NFL.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't need to play.
Does it affect their scholarship though?
That's the thing. They can't, the NCAA cannot protect, like, let's say these kids get sick, some die.
Mm-hmm.
NCAA, they're making them sign waivers, bro, to play. So that they're not liable for anything that happens.
That's
already don't get paid. So now you're making them sign health waivers.
Health waivers.
So if they catch the corona, then They don't. You're not liable for nothing. Now they have to come up with these kids that come into the college that they're not getting paid from the NCAA.
Yeah.
Which is making billions.
Yeah, making.
You know what I mean? They're not getting paid from there, so there's no health coverage.
That's
they get sick.
Trash, man.
So why trash. To me is they shouldn't play at all.
You know,
don't play.
Like this player should boycott shit like that.
A couple of percentage of those kids are going to the NFL. Yeah. And some percentage is gonna go play Canada, small percentage is gonna play overseas. But it's too small of a percentage for how many players that actually play in the NCAA that to me is just it's not worth it. And I completely agree with pushing the season. Push the season back. Maybe they can have a vaccine by the time y'all want to play.
But do people really want to take that vaccine?
Oh, no. I saw that they said the government could make people do, what's it called? Make it mandatory.
Make it mandatory.
So it's like, let's say if you don't want to take it, you can't even get into, like, you can't go to work.
Wait, the government is going to make it mandatory?
They say... I watched the thing on the news where mm-hmm. they were saying it could be possible that the government make a man because then you can't go to work without a paperwork.
Yeah.
You can't go into certain stores without paperwork. You can't fly without paperwork.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So it could end up being mandatory.
It's about to get real. Yeah. Once vaccines start coming out,
when it comes to that,
it's going
to
get real.
That kind of vaccine shit, I'm good, man.
No, I'm good too.
You know what the fuck they trying to put in you, man?
Yes. Yes. You know, I'm good. And I could see a big change in the next 5 to 6 years. Like the way, like, first of all, you know, we should forget about what we used to do because everything is changing now.
Everything's changed. It's different.
But the amount of like pressure they're going to put on people when it comes to these vaccines, I think is going to literally change the way we see things.
Yeah.
Think about schools. Think about, you know, just like, going shopping, flying, all that stuff. Like,
that's what I'm saying. They could make it mandatory.
It's,
but again, like, well, back to the subject is, that's why I really don't think players should play. I don't think none of the players should play just because of they don't have health insurance. They're not covered for shit. They're not covered. The prospects could be upset.
No.
But those are two to three players per team that will actually make it into the league.
Yeah. Nah. If they have to go through all these conditions, then yeah, I'm all for that. Push that back,
yeah,
like, you know,
push it back, man.
These colleges are not paying.
Yeah,
you for
they're not
shit.
Paying you for shit. Yeah, y'all players. That's America is built on making money.
Yes.
You tell me you have kids that's making a school billions of dollars every single year. Yes. Coaches are getting paid
signed to millions. Yes.
Coaches are getting paid millions. More
extensions like
and
5 years.
And you telling me the kids that are coming that are trying to find away for their families. They're coming from
they can't get
crazy backgrounds. Even the ones that aren't coming from crazy backgrounds, you can't even
$40,000 a year.
You have to go to school, get a job, and play football.
Impossible.
Come on.
The amount of training those kids go through, they're not finding a second job out there.
But the craziest thing is how they spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on gyms and stadiums.
Millions, bro. Look at the facilities.
No, I said thousands.
A1. I mean, yeah, A1.
Hundreds of millions. My bad. Hundreds of millions of dollars on I seen. I think is it Alabama's. I seen one of the gyms.
That's top notch.
Or Oklahoma. Mm-hmm. One of their gyms, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, ridiculous.
Yeah,
it was like a mile.
I bet.
Just equipment.
Yeah.
I'm like, come on, that doesn't even make any sense.
Doesn't.
But then those players cannot get paid just for even there's their own signature on stuff. If you're putting their face on a shirt,
look at that.
You can't give them a percentage
for
their own face or their jersey name. That's the name their parents gave them.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And they can't get paid off
that. They can't get paid off that. They can't make any money. And
that's crazy.
And I know they all have like this aspiration of making it to the league, but not everybody's.
It's not realistic.
It. Yeah.
It's a small percentage, man. It's not realistic. No matter how you break it down, it's not realistic.
Pay the kids. Pay them.
Yeah, yo. These kids need to be paid. And I agree with completely not playing. I'm with it. If I was in college football, like I'd be like, yeah, I ain't trying to play. I opt out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we could just go into the next thing we're talking about, which is the NFL players opting out.
Yeah, yeah.
67 or something so far that opted out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? To me, even in the NFL, If I don't want to come, if I got a family at home and I'm not trying to take that risk, because the hardest thing, like NBA could do it, because 12 players per team.
Yeah.
That's like you got coaches, 12 players per team, blah, blah.
Yeah.
They could do that.
The
NFL is 50-something, 53 starters. And that's just the start. 50, well, not starters, but 53 active. And then you have the backup.
Yeah.
people.
Yeah.
And then you got the coaches.
Yeah.
Their coaches, their assistants.
It's,
you know what I mean? You got the trainers, you got all that, all those people.
Everything is all tackle, touching,
so many, sweat, so all that many stuff. People.
Yeah.
There's no way. The NFL, there's no way.
Nah.
There's people, there's people quarantined at home that's still playing. They're going to play in the league.
They'll play. I think the NFL season will go on, but
it'll go on. But I think it'll be like baseball where, well, not like baseball. Baseball's been able to actually contain it too. Like the NBA.
For real?
Yeah, only two teams have
two gotten, teams. Okay.
And they have to do is just because it's baseball. Mm-hmm. Those teams just don't play for a week or two. They got so many games anyway.
Oh yeah, they do.
It's not like NFL. You don't play for, if you get your best player on the team doesn't play for 2 weeks, now that's your own two and shit. If your best quarterback gets the corona, 2 weeks, you're fucked.
0-2.
You're 0-2 automatically.
16 games.
You know what I mean? So it's different when it comes to baseball, and
because
baseball's still playing. They're still playing the game.
Oh yeah, they are.
You know what I mean? And they've been able to, other than two teams, for the most part, they get tested all the time and they're good. Basketball, they get tested and they're good. And anybody that violates the rules, they suspend them and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? But for like, you know, when it comes to the football thing, that's why I say it's hard to quarantine, because like the player from the Seahawks, fuck his name.
Yeah.
I don't know. His name doesn't even matter.
Yeah.
But he's they say he had a small chance of making it onto the team anyway.
Yeah.
But he's cornerback, I think?
Yeah, CB, yeah.
All right, so he's a cornerback. And what this guy did is he basically tried to sneak a girl in.
Yeah.
he tried to sneak a girl into the team hotel.
Yeah.
With her wearing team gear.
Team gear.
She looked like a player.
I don't even understand how that is. I would like to see the video. I want to see the video.
I was searching for the video. I couldn't find it.
I want to see the video.
Video out there. But he, oh man, I don't even know where to begin. Yo, all right. This is just a life lesson. If you're trying to get into anything, man, anything in your life, you worked your whole life for this opportunity, man.
Yeah.
And to allow vagina to stop you from getting there, it's crazy.
Oh man.
Like you really needed it that bad. You're in a team hotel. They said nobody's outside is allowed to come in. Only traveling people with the team.
Yes.
Is allowed to be there. To me, why does idiot just didn't get an Airbnb? Because they allow some players to quarantine at home.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So why is idiot, isn't it? If he might be broke. Like he might be.
He's broke because like I read that they signed him to a $2,000 bonus. That's not,
that ain't shit. That ain't shit. But you just you're gonna try and make your way on.
Yeah, like you could work his way.
Literally,
you had a chance. You have a chance.
The chance. You worked your whole life since you were a kid.
Yeah.
You worked your whole life for this.
You don't have no, like, you know, Russell Wilson status. You're trying to make a name for yourself.
You were outside. Like, they say you had a slim chance of making it. All you had to do, put your head down, focus, practice hard, work hard.
Yes. And respect.
And even if you didn't make that team, you had the opportunity to make 31 other teams.
Yep. And your respect.
And right now, because of this situation, he will probably never play play for any team.
Yes.
Because of that.
Because
they know you are that stupid.
That's like, what is it? Gross negligence?
Straight
because
up.
Because you don't even care about your team.
Your decision making.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, man.
That's the most idiotic
terrible.
Shit.
Terrible, yeah.
Idiotic
yeah.
shit. I couldn't believe it. I'm like, bro, your whole life you worked for this opportunity. And you're going to fuck it up for pussy. Like, what is wrong with yo?
Yeah.
Fellas, get the vagina off your mind. If you're trying to accomplish something in your life, when you're in that shit, when you're working for that, get the vagina off your mind. Unless you know you got a woman that's just gonna hold you down. Like the dudes that have wives and shit at home, they understand, you gotta go do your thing. And for them, they should be actually happy, because this is a time when these players can't even have chicks around. Because usually they traveling.
Yo,
they can do whatever the fuck they want. But this is the time when they can't even bring girls into the hotel room. But this guy tried to put on a fucking...
And this team, thing just started. The training just started.
You telling me this shit just started and you couldn't even go a week or two without vagina? You needed it that bad. You have a problem, bro.
He had a plan.
He did. He planned
He had a diabolical
plan. Yo, and he thought that plan would work. Like, you cannot put a girl in football gear and act like she's a player, bro.
I don't know.
Make her seem like she was a player. That's
I would
crazy.
Like to see that video.
These players are huge, man.
Yo, that's ridiculous.
Unless she was shaped like fucking, what's her name? Precious and shit. Unless she look like a linebacker. Like, how you gonna put gear on her, man? I didn't even see the girl. I really want to see the video because I want to see how big the girl is. Because
I bet you he was. I don't think she was bigger.
Unless she was like, you know what I mean, some big ass chick that looked like a linebacker. There was no fucking way, man.
That's
like,
ridiculous.
You're an idiot.
Yeah,
you gotta be stupid.
Like, you can't put your teammates in danger because you want to get some. That's just ridiculous.
You can't, man. You sound crazy. Yeah. And like, to me, if I was his dad, I would beat the shit out of him. Yo, you're not coming back home. Figure it out. Now you're a man. Figure it out. Tell that girl to take you in.
Since you're making decisions, right?
Since you're making stupid ass decisions, tell that girl to take you in. You're not coming back home. You bugger. Figure that shit out.
Nah, that's nuts. You had
how you gonna call your mom on the phone and be like, hey, yo, ma, they let me go. Why?
What was the reason?
Oh, I tried to sneak a chicken. You've been there for a week or two, bro. What are you doing?
That's the thing. ESPN. A week or two, you've been there, bro. ESPN carried it. ESPN carried it. So that's just like you're that guy at this point. You're that guy.
He is that guy. Anyway. He's an idiot. Now you just hurt yourself from making it. I hope he can make it into like Canada or something. You know what I'm saying?
They don't because care. If he's good, yeah.
You'd hate to, like, to me, is when shit like this happens, he's young, so it's like, bro, learn from it, man.
Hopefully like, you get another chance. Protect yourself,
man. If that's not your, like, you shouldn't even be sneaking your wife into that. Even if that was your wife. Like, she can't be there.
No.
You should be at home. Yo, when I'm done with this shit, I'll come
like,
see you.
This is the reason why, men like that should have a good team around them that could advise you not to make stupid decisions. Yo, like that.
Just work hard. Leave the vagina alone. When you're working for the shit, just leave the vagina alone, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's not just for dudes. That's just for ladies too. It's like, if you're trying to focus, leave the dick alone.
Yeah, bro, I get it. But like, if you're an NFL player,
you work your whole life.
Any NFL player out there, make sure you select a good team that will advise you, that will lead you to a right path of your success. LeBron James is an example of that. Like, LeBron James is not the smartest out there, but he has a good team in his corner. And those are his friends, right?
His crew that he grew up with.
So he has a good team that is protecting his interest. Yeah. Now, I could say, like, you know, maybe that dude, because, you know, the way he came up, like, you know, he wasn't top notch.
He's a child.
But
that's all it was.
Do you have an uncle? Do you have a father? Do you have friends that are advising you well?
They could do shit in that situation. Because, well, anybody that's home, like uncles, fathers and shit, it's his teammates that should have been like, yo, like, terrible idea, yo. If any of his teammates knew, which I don't know.
I don't know.
But if any of his teammates knew and they didn't tell him like, yo, nah.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do that shit, because this is an opportunity you will never get again.
Yes.
You are trying. Yes. That's my thing too. You're not on the team, bro. Like, yes. Where if he was on the team, they just suspend him for a couple games.
Yeah.
If you were on the team and you were a starter,
yeah,
they suspend you for, or even if you, let's say you were a backup. As a backup, they might let you go, but another team will easily pick you up because you're a backup.
Yeah.
But bro, you didn't even make a practice squad yet.
Nah.
You're not even a scouting team.
Decision making.
You're not nothing.
Zero.
You were trying to make it on a team and you decide to be so stupid, yeah, that you've been playing football your whole life.
Yeah.
On all levels, elementary level, middle school, high school, college. You did all these years. Yes. You trained all those hours.
Yeah.
For some vagina.
Yeah. To lose it. To lose it because of
and it's probably some not even some what.
Let's not even go there.
If that shit was a what, then I got to talk more.
No, I don't care if it was what or not.
Yo, what if it was what?
Care.
What if she?
I don't
like,
care.
What if her shit was like? A
I don't care. I don't care.
What if it's like just throwing me?
No,
into
I don't
ocean,
care.
Yo, that shit is.
I don't care. I wet the ocean in, put some suction cup on it. When I'm done with my practice, then we can now talk about
it. What if she be dripping?
No.
You know what I'm saying? What if she make the shit disappear? Like,
no.
She could be doing some wild shit.
Then.
Nah. All jokes aside.
Oh, yeah.
All jokes aside, he shouldn't be doing that, man. That was just stupid. You know what I mean? You come that far in your life and you just gonna ruin it by trying to sneak a girl.
You had a plan.
I really want to see that girl, bro. I think if she looked like a
premeditated
linebacker, I'll be dying.
I think the video.
How big she looked.
Man, they better TMZ release. Where's TMZ?
I need that TMZ video. TMZ, you listening? I need y'all to release that video because I want to see how big this girl is. Because if she, how he tried to get her in, if she not as big as him,
Oh man,
then he's bugging.
Is a cornerback? How he's big are you as a cornerback? It's probably like 5'10", like small.
Yeah,
like
five. Well, yeah, they're probably shorter than us because most cornerbacks are like 5'10" and shit.
Yeah, they're like they're
so small, they're shorter than us. Yeah. But I mean, it's like our size though.
Yeah,
you know what I mean,
but
so she got to be precious. She got to be big. A five ten. Yeah, I mean, you
not, what? What if she was probably like small? That's trying what I'm to saying. Act like he's a freaking
a player, bro. That's what
punter.
I don't know. Hey, I gotta see. You gotta see what color she is too. That's important.
Why is that important? It's
important. Because if she was white, the only person you could quarterback punter, like, because oh no, I just think about it. This. Now some racist shit, but this shit's gonna sound mad racist. But the if you look at positions, right?
Yeah.
You get now it's more mixture in quarterbacks.
Yeah.
So quarterbacks now we have a mixture, but mostly it's always been white.
Mostly, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But you got can't be she can't. If she's white, can't come in as a quarterback, can't come in as any defensive back player because they're all black.
Yeah.
Right? You can't come in as a wide receiver because they're all black except for like three in the league. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And she can't be a lineman unless she's precious looking. she gotta be big as hell. So the only other thing that leaves is a punter.
A punter
or a kicker. You need to see what color she is. That's important.
I would love to see the disguise.
I think if she's white, yo, black people are gonna go nuts. They're gonna kill him on Twitter. Yo, black Twitter is gonna kill him. If she's white, black Twitter is gonna kill him.
Wow.
I really wanna see. I wanna see what color she is though.
I
hope she's Spanish. Just for his sake.
What? At the end of the day, my dude lost a job. I don't care who she is.
That's facts. He better go back. Nah, it's too late though. It's too late. They fired him already.
It's too late. ESPN carried it. That means no team.
What do you say though? Like
to what?
To the girl.
After the situation, or
if it was you,
we tried. It didn't work.
Yo, would you still be like, yo, I'm gonna still need that pussy? Or in that situation, you got fired and it's like, nah, fuck.
I mean, I'm a let the emotions run out. After the emotions run out, if it's somebody that I really care about, I'm still in it.
I hope it's somebody you cares about.
Yeah. That's if you're on some like random that you found on like, you know what, girls only.
Yeah.
That's trash, bro.
Nah, I think it has to be a girl that he really liked though. Cause that'd be a crazy risk for somebody you just
met. That doesn't make sense. I didn't even think she was going to make it to the facility and all that is already quarantined.
Yeah,
what were you thinking? Were other people doing it? Were other players doing it and they outed him out?
He probably just got caught. No, he got caught.
He probably the one that got caught. I bet you other players probably.
But they said those players at home quarantining. So it's like, I don't understand. If players at home, bro, get an Airbnb.
I don't. Can he afford that?
No, they're cheap. We can afford it. We get an Airbnb every time we travel.
Like, hey, but man, this dude could have made. I don't know if he could have made a name for himself, but you had an opportunity.
If that deep, Airbnb.
Yeah.
Or idiot should have just had her come in with a hotel. The hotel gear. Talk to the hotel. Be like, yo, let me get one of the hotel the cleaning ladies. Let me get one of their gear. Give it to her.
Are they allowed to live their bubble for a few hours?
I don't know.
Go somewhere?
I don't know how that they do that. I don't know.
Okay.
But what I'm saying is, mm-hmm. It would have been better. He's clearly not smart.
He's
what I would have done.
Definitely not.
You get the cleaning lady's gear.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd be like, yo, put this on. Act like you're a cleaning lady. Talk to somebody in the hotel. Be like, yo, yeah, you know I mean?
Housekeeping.
Housekeeping. I got some shit going on. Let her up. Here's a few bucks. Good.
I guess it could have been slick like that.
Bro, you got to be slick. You got to be smarter, man. If you're going to get caught up, you can't be on some stupid shit where...
Like a Seahawks gear.
She's in Seahawks gear? Yeah. Are you stupid? He's too cheap. That's what happens when you're too cheap.
He probably used his own jersey number.
Probably did. Too cheap. When you're too cheap, that's what happens, man. Like, you can't be doing that shit. But, like, you know, just to wrap this thing up, man, if you're trying to do some shit, just be smart, man.
Yeah.
Don't let no dick, no vagina get in the way of whatever you're trying to accomplish, because that shit just... He'll fuck you up, clearly.
Moral of the story, please.
Yeah, that shit will fuck you up. But let's keep it to the quarantining though. Talk about, you know, the pandemic and shit, you know, kids going back to school, people's mental health and shit.
Yeah. With this pandemic, and one thing people probably don't talk about, because, you know, maybe stigma out there, is the mental health that people will probably go through in this pandemic. The fear of
you know, catching the coronavirus, the fear of going to places, the anxiety level, like initially when everybody was panicking, rushing in the stores and all that stuff. Yeah. You don't know, you were panicking if you don't know if you're going to see, you know, food in the stores in the next month, and all that stuff, you know, could create trauma, yeah, you know, sure, in ourselves, like, you know. So I know some people are probably going through a lot of mental health in that, like, you know, it's I would say seek help.
And the suicide rate is out, right?
And the suicide rate, divorce rate.
So it goes to show y'all, people you guys can't even stand y'all significant others, which is crazy. Get to know people. That's all it tells. That's all this thing tells you is people don't get to know each other enough, man.
No, people do not.
The fact that you don't want to, that you can't even survive your relationship spending this much time together is crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. It is crazy. And like, you know, this is my experience. Like, America is not the type of country that, you know, maybe other people experience it, but I feel like America is not the type of country where you can know, where you, in your neighborhood, you know everybody, and you know what's going on. I'm not saying you're like trying to snoop around or whatever, but you know that their well-being,
yeah, yeah.
So, you know, because I grew up in a community like that where, like, you know, my neighbors know my first and last name. They would come and eat with us and everything. It was like almost like a community family type of thing. But over here, you could have a neighbor and not even know his name.
Yeah, in 10 years. But that's only it's the crime thing though. People are scared of their
people are scared of it. Yes.
I mean, like my parents' neighborhood, a lot of people leave their garage open during the day.
Yeah.
No crime over there. So they leave the garage doors open during the day.
Yeah.
And that's almost everybody in the. But there's certain spots in America where it's like that, where you can just, you know, leave your garage door open, leave your door unlocked, and but then there's other certain parts where it's like you do that and you just asking for it,
Like someone's already looking, and you know,
yeah. But like when it comes to the whole mental health, you know, people just find something that, you know, like you could, that could be your outlet, you know, something that's not, you know, like drugs and shit. I mean, you could smoke weed though. If you smoke weed though, do your thing. But anything stronger than that. But like, you know, don't go into no like popping pills or anything stronger than that. But like for me, it's, you know, do something that gets your mental right, you know. Mm-hmm. Whether it's, you know, you go for hikes. I know a lot of people are going on hikes now.
Even if
you need to talk to somebody, if you need your friends, like start hanging out with your friends more, you know, like y'all could do hang out in the house and shit.
Yeah, yeah. You know, connect with your family.
If you've been estranged from somebody or some people, maybe it might be time to reconnect.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just to get your mental space right. Just do something.
Yeah.
Other than sitting in the house, you know, just being in your own mind.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what it gets people, is like being in your own mind.
Yeah.
Some people are like introverted and shit, but like not having the option to be able to do things.
I think
is what's kind of killing people, is, you know, just not having the option.
Yes.
You know?
And then not being able to even step out the house and do certain things that you normally do, that could put you, like, it's almost like you're going through a withdrawal.
Yeah.
You know, and I look at the unemployment rate. The unemployment rate is high, and if you're stuck in the house or you're looking for a job and maybe you can't find a job,
put your focus on something.
You know, focus on something. And
focus on something.
And if you can't think of anything, you know. Don't try to narrow it down. Like, let your options be open, and you know, then start cutting away.
Yeah, ladies, if you want to start OnlyFans, you know what I mean, do your thing. I support you 100%.
I don't know how that helps with your mental health, but okay.
That's to bring the bread in. Depressed from if you're depressed from not having any bread, you know what I mean, and then the unemployment hasn't hit yet. It should have been hit for almost everybody, but if it hasn't hit yet, you know what I mean. You're trying to start. I know a couple of girls are doing OnlyFans. Shout out to you guys, by the way, all the women doing OnlyFans. But yeah, you know, if you need some type of income, you know, you're doing your thing. I support.
Yeah,
support your peoples, and that's one thing too. Support your peoples. Whatever they get into, support them. You know, but that goes into if you just to just get your mind right, you know, talk to somebody, talk to counselors. I know they have like online counseling or stuff like that, you know.
Seek help. Like, you know,
don't be afraid to ask for help. Definitely.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to ask for help. What is friends or family? Just even if you just need to just talk to anybody. Just hit up on your friend. If you don't have no friends, then you know what I mean?
Like some people usually feel like, oh, they won't understand me.
If you talk, they will.
They'll mock me. You know, like, you know, some men actually go through like some kind of depression, but they don't want to spill it out to their friends.
I'm the type I'll mock you, but I'll also listen to you and tell you the truth. But I will laugh at you though.
I'll
tell you the truth right after.
But I don't know if I would want to laugh at somebody that's going through something.
No. There's always, all right, that is my thing. There's a joke in everything, right? Everything, almost everything.
Okay.
And as well. So I'm the type where it's like, I find a funny in whatever it is. But okay. If you got some serious shit, of course, I'm not going to start off laughing at you. I'm just saying, like, during the conversation, there'll be some laughs to make you feel better. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Definitely. That's what I'm saying. Definitely.
It's not like, you got to tell me like, yo, I'm depressed like a motherfucker, yo.
Say, man, the fuck up, pussy.
Yeah, I ain't got no. I just be like, yo, man, the fuck up, yo. You know what I mean? We all go through things. nah, it wouldn't be like that. It wouldn't be that. I'd straight up, like, listen as a friend and tell the truth and that. And then over the time, you know what I mean? We'll get some jokes in where, you know, help you feel a little better. You know what I mean? Get you feeling right. You get it? Like, I'm the type, I'll listen. I'll crack jokes and shit, but I'll listen, though.
I feel like that's important, just to have that, you know, that person, that go to. And even if you don't seek help out there, they're counselors, they're
online counselors too.
And they don't have to, you know, all those things are confidential. Some people are going through shit.
Some real shit.
Imagine if like, listen, a girl or guy was like, you know, I don't know, molested, and they're still going through that. That's an example, and now it's affected their mental health. Maybe they don't want to tell me. Maybe they don't want to tell, like, you know, but confidential. That's how you have the therapist and all that stuff. So like, but with the pandemic, there's a lot of people that are going through it. There's a lot of people that are going through it, and we need to make aware of that, and you know, help yourself.
Find an outlet. That's what's super important is finding an outlet, a way to get whatever stress you have in your mind out. You know, like, I know working out is not for everybody. You know, that's my way.
Going
to the gym. That's my way. But something like that's not for everybody. Even if you want to pick up a new hobby, pick up, I don't know, knitting, something.
Something. Yeah. Something
that just make you something that'll just safe, put your mind at ease.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just something that would calm your mind.
Yes.
Where you're focused on, so you don't have to be thinking about exactly what's going on in that moment. Something that you could just wake up every day and be like, yeah, that's what I'm trying to get to, or that's what I'm trying to accomplish. Like, find a goal.
Yeah,
this is what I'm trying to accomplish. Blah blah blah.
Yeah,
and you know, you set out to do it, keeps your mind off.
Yeah,
all the bullshit until, you know, the world comes back to being a better place, or if you're going through like a divorce or you know, anything else. Find something, focus on it.
I agree.
Because that helps a lot. And if you're somebody who has a hard time focusing, ask for help or find other people that are into that same thing. And that's,
I agree. There are people like, they let themselves get into that depressed state where they feel like
to come out.
Nothing. And when you get into that state, it's very, very hard to
come. It's hard to find out.
So I would advise anybody, if you're feeling that way, do not get into that hole.
It's a dark place, man.
Yes, really do not. Yeah. But do something meaningful, like, you know, some people just working alone, just working, interacting with people, or just going out there, finding new hobbies could get you off, you know, that state of mind, you know.
And that's the thing too. Like, I'm one of those people. I'm super like outgoing. I enjoy being around people and shit. So like, you know, I was lucky that my job still kept running.
Because
the human interaction and shit. Like, I enjoy that. I enjoy being around people. I'm super extrovert. So it's, I enjoy being around people and conversing with people. So for people who are the opposite, I can see it.
Yeah.
Like, you're just especially in the beginning, you just in the house. but nobody, like
nobody,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And even for me, like, let's say, like, my thing was I couldn't, you know, doing the whole races and traveling mm-hmm, around. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We were restricted from traveling.
Yeah.
That I felt like a caged bird. So I can only imagine.
Yeah.
People that are told to be in the house because yeah. you can't go to work and can't, shit.
Yep,
your
yep.
job is shut down and, you know, your marriage is falling apart, or, you know, school, you can't go to school yep. for kids, you know, because yep. I mean? Kids, you know, they go through it.
Yeah.
You can't go to school and shit like that. And it's tough.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough.
It's tough. Tough. And parents too, like, you know, if you see your kids, like if you see signs and shit, man, just yeah. get your kids some help.
Yeah.
Or talk yes. to them. If you have that kind of relationship, because I know not all parents have that kind of relationship with their kid where the kid wants to talk to them. But if the kid doesn't want to talk to you, find him somebody that they'll talk to.
And
yeah. Right, shout out to all the counselors though.
No, yeah. shout out to them.
Y'all big time. Y'all big time. Yeah. Y'all doing y'all thing in this time of need.
Shout out to the counselors that don't push medication once someone comes to them.
Word. Shout out to the counselors that talk.
Yeah, that actually knows what was going on.
Exactly. Like. And find ways to, you know, have people interact with, you know, getting things out of people without having to medicate them right away and shit.
Yeah, like, you know, so, oh, yeah, I'm depressed. Let's take some Zyrtec or some shit like that. Or man, some,
that's allergy, bro.
That's allergy.
you still got me. You just gonna stop sneezing.
Like, why did I stop sneezing? But my mental state is still fucked up. Oh,
that's allergies.
That was funny. Oh, maybe like Ativan.
But nah. For all the counselors, man. Anybody who's a therapist. Anybody yeah. who's, you know, is in therapy, any type of therapy, whether it's mental or physical, like, you know, massage spas and those kind of.
Yeah, yeah.
Them too. You know what I mean? Because that shit releases.
The massage. Yo, massage oh my spa, God. Man. Yeah. That's,
you guys are the best too. You know what I mean? I'd love getting me a massage. It's running a little too expensive these days, but you know what I mean? Once in a while, when you want to treat yourself.
Yeah.
But now what else we got on the docket, man? Got anything, or we just
do that? Have you heard?
All right, yeah. So we're gonna take y'all into the segment because, you know, times are running. Take y'all into the segment. It's called Have You Heard? We don't want to be sitting here all day, you know, just keep talking and talking about different things during the week because we'll be here for like 5 hours. So we got a small segment. We just run through things real quick. I guess we might as well. We didn't really talk about this when we're talking about the mental health thing, but it's like the kids going back to school.
Yeah.
There was a girl in Atlanta that got suspended for that picture.
Yeah,
posted it on there. She got suspended for like a couple of days.
What did you think about that?
Bullshit. Fuck the schools. You know what I mean?
Yo, schools.
Them kids, they had the option to wear the mask or not, which is stupid because a lot of schools right now are on quarantine anyway.
Yeah.
Like, well, what was the point? Like, you're going to just open up just to do that shit.
Just do the online shit.
Do it online.
Teach, like, you know, I think just get the kids tablets or whatever. And
all of them. Yo, we have enough money to supply every child with a fucking tablet. Even if they're little, because the one thing I was talking to a teacher and she said, the one is, it's like, it's hard to make little kids focus. Like, if you're teaching little kids, that's tough.
That's.
But the parents, fucking listen, man. If you have a child who is in elementary school or some shit, make that kid focus. Sit there with that kid. Sit with your child.
Yeah.
You're at home anyway. Sit with your child and make sure that child focuses on what the teacher's teaching. Because at that point, your child could get
education. If you're home with your child, why don't you just homeschool them
You don't have to home. If you want the teacher to teach them, the school supplies the tablet.
Okay.
Have you sit down? Oh, with your child sit down with your child.
Yeah, like that's yeah.
Sit nah, down with that, your goddamn child.
I don't even think that it's that long because it's everything not. Would be yeah.
Sit down with your goddamn child and have your child learn, so you don't have to send them to school to go get sick. You know what I mean, then your child's gonna come infect everybody in the house. Sit down with your child. If you have the opportunity and your school supplies is, I think every school's doing well. They should. For the schools that are doing it, y'all parents need to step up. You know, grandparents too, whoever's taking care of the child, because some people, you know what I mean, the grandparents.
Yeah.
So whoever's taking care of the child, whether it's if your older brother who's taking care of your little brother, whoever's doing it, sit with that child.
Yeah.
Especially if they're little. If they're older, then they could do it themselves. But for the little kids, I know it's hard for them to focus because they're all over the place. Mm-hmm. But cause they said like one kid would be like, one kid would be shirtless eating Pop-Tarts. Another kid's falling asleep. Like, I was like,
what? Yeah, because it's, you know how hard it is? Like, you know.
Kids, yo, little kids, they're funny as shit, man. But nah, parents, that's why parents need to
parents.
Sit there with their kids, parents. Man. This is the time.
Parents.
Teachers already do enough. this is the time when y'all need to help.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But yeah, nah, I think it's bullshit they send that girl home. But what was dope though is she got like a nice little tour around the country doing fucking interviews and shit. Interviews. That was dope.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Good. Good.
Yeah, that's all the school did. So it was like, fuck you to the school.
Yeah.
Because y'all suspended her, but then she got a nice little tour to go do interviews because of the picture she posted.
Post
that pic. How you gonna suspend her? Y'all created the situation. You know what I'm saying?
Well, then they need to come up with a better protocol.
Better protocol. But they were, I know they were saying like, it'd be like half and half. Mm-hmm. Half the kids go to school, half to stay home. So it's not as many kids. But I mean, Atlanta, Florida, and all them southern states don't give a fuck.
They don't, man. They don't.
Okay, I seen them firsthand. They don't give a fuck.
They don't. They don't.
Not at all. Which is crazy.
I mean, I'm not mad at them.
Yeah, nah. I mean, they want to be outside. Be outside.
Yeah.
I mean, you taking a risk. Just protect your children. Protect the elders. You know, or the people that are prone to getting sick.
Yeah.
Anybody with asthma and stuff. But yeah. Another thing is I know people heard Amber Geiger's filing for an appeal, which is crazy to me. You know, she already got off light.
I know.
10 years is light.
Very light.
So her getting off light, she's trying to get it reduced to like 2 or 3 years, which is crazy.
I think it will happen.
It's an appeal. You're allowed to appeal.
You're allowed to appeal, yeah.
But I think it's bullshit, though. But you, I mean, with the law and stuff, yeah, she's allowed to appeal.
Allowed.
But to me, then that goes to show, like, dude's brother giving her a hug and shit. Like, come on, bro. You know what I mean? Now look,
I don't know.
You thought she was gonna take the 10?
Yeah, no.
You know what I mean? She's gonna try and finesse her way to taking only 2 or 3. But I hope it doesn't. I'm gonna keep following it. Excuse me. Anybody else? You know, if you're interested, just keep following it because I think this is important. Like she killed a dude that was sitting on his own couch, man. You know what I mean? So it's. I'm gonna keep following it because I hope they deny her the appeal. Let her do her time.
I won't be surprised if she gets the appeal.
She got off light.
I know she did, but I won't be surprised if she gets.
She got off light, man. She should do the time. Like she shouldn't. Like to me, I say she shouldn't fight it because you already got off light. But
she don't care about that.
She don't give a fuck.
Yeah, she definitely don't. As far as she's concerned, right now she is mourned. She's done now. She wants to.
She's giving the hug.
Yep.
Fucking guy. Yo, if I was killed, don't give nobody a hug.
Hell no.
If somebody kill me, man, don't give them. Do not forget. Man. I don't give a fuck.
Hell the fuck.
That's how I be, man.
Mostly
hugging your brother's killer is wild.
Mostly that kind of murder.
Yeah. Senseless.
That kind of murder.
Senseless, bro.
You know, so
you don't give her a hug.
It's not.
Kids bugging.
You don't give her a hug like, you know, you
somebody needs to check on him.
Your brother cannot, you know, live his life, cannot have kids. Yeah. Cannot prolong each generation. That's a generation done right there.
That's what I'm saying. Sometimes bugging. Black people are too forgiving, bro. Like I'll be looking at shit. Way too bugging. Forgiving, man.
Yeah. Like what do you? What do you?
In that
what
situation, I'll be like, nah,
ain't this? Oh, that's what both of them would want.
Fuck out of here.
The fuck?
Fuck out of it. That's all.
Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
Now, I would not want that. He would not want that.
Yeah. How do you know what he wants?
I don't know. Do that. He would not want that. If he could tell you from the grave, he would tell you, nah, you bugging. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy. Yeah.
That's what it would want.
Nah.
Nah.
Yeah. We forgot to do the credit shit. You want to touch that on the next
one? We can save.
Yeah, we'll save. We had a good one for y'all, but we'll save it for the next one though. I guess the other thing is we got a Have You Heard segment for, I guess, Kamala Harris. She's the VP.
I knew she was going to get picked.
I knew too. I seen like a couple of weeks before it happened. And he had a piece of paper in his hand with her name on it and all her qualities and shit. I seen it already.
She could be the one.
She's hated though.
No, but she could be the one going against Trump though at the end of the day.
Oh, no. Oh, yeah, that's the one. Like, she's really good when it comes, like, the vice president, when they have their
own debate and stuff.
When they have the debate?
Yeah.
She's going to kill Duke. Like, she's really good when it comes
she's
to
gonna
debate.
She's going to kill Pence?
She's going to kill him. It's not even gonna be. She's nice with the debates.
But I could see her going for Trump.
Well, when it comes, oh, no.
Dementia Biden?
Remember what I tell you? I told you.
Mm-hmm.
it's important to whoever his vice president is, mm-hmm. is who we got to vote for, because I do not believe Biden's going to make the 4 years. He's not. If he wins, he's not making it through the 4 years.
He's going to be 82 in 4 years. Yeah, he's not making it through.
Like how Obama's hair turned
mm-hmm.
within that time.
Yeah.
That stress. Biden ain't making it.
He's going to be like a skeleton, but he's fucking thin.
He'll just be a face.
Yeah.
He's not going to make it. So it's like, it's important whoever's going to get behind. And so I think before the 4 years is over, we'll have our first female president.
Yeah, yeah, I think so. Let's see if they win.
Let's
see if they win. Yeah. Because if they win, that's gonna happen.
But from what they're saying, this should be easy for Trump. That's what they said.
It should be.
She's hated.
Yeah, it should be a landslide.
For Trump.
Democrats have no idea what they're doing.
Yeah, when it comes to that. They're saying that it should be a landslide for Trump because she's hated a lot by people.
I don't know her profile. I probably have to read up on her. She's a prosecutor.
She was. Yeah, they said she used to hold out DNA evidence from people that were locked up that were found out innocent later.
Damn.
Yeah, she's hated.
Damn.
Yeah.
I guess she's like part black, part Indian. She's Indian.
Yeah. So, but she's hated by a lot of black people though. Black people don't like her. Yeah. From what the polls say.
I never believe polls.
Just saying that's what they're saying. That's what's out there. That's where I see everything from everywhere. They're saying that she's not well liked among the minorities.
Well,
and the fact that she was a prosecutor holding evidence against minorities. So
that's wild.
Yeah. So we'll see how that goes. People just pay attention, you know, because this is important.
Yeah.
Pay attention because this is our future, our next 4 years. So, you know, if you guys, you should vote no matter what, no matter your feelings, just vote. No, because it's important. But we'll move on to the next. AMC Theater is opening up.
Yep. And they're giving
15-cent movies.
15-cent movies.
Well, I think they're going to do half capacity, right? Because of COVID and shit. It's probably only going to sell a couple of tickets because everybody
tickets.
Has to stay away from each other.
Yes, yeah. Definitely. But 15 cents to start up, though?
Yeah, 15 cents. So, you know, if you want to go to the movies, if you itching for that, I kind of, if you're somebody... Oh, we got to get into that too. We'll do that on the next one.
Okay.
I'll put that down for going places by yourself, like the movies and shit. Because I know some of y'all weird out here that go to movies by yourselves. But we'll talk about that another time, though. I think y'all are weird, but I'll dig into that one. But yeah, now if you want to go to the movies, 15 cents AMC Theaters, look them up. They're starting to open. And I guess the last thing we'll get into is... the boxing and UFC. So right now, there's a fight, I guess, this weekend.
Yes.
By the time you guys hear this, the fight already happened. We recorded it before the fight. So by the time you guys hear this, the Stipe and Cormier fight already happened this weekend.
Let's make some picks.
I pick Cormier.
I pick Stipe.
Yeah,
no. Cormier is, I don't know, he's a fat dude.
He's fat, but he's athletic fat.
I don't know.
But I pick Cormier, though. I go with him. I think he gonna.
I don't
take
like
it.
Him because I don't he like was him. Talking shit for. Jones.
Yeah.
That shit we did in John Jones made me not like him.
I'm a big John Jones fan, even though he's a fuck up.
Stipe, let's go.
That's my guy, but I think Cormier is gonna take it. And then we got Mike Tyson and Roy Jones got pushed back to November.
Oh man,
anybody was really waiting for that November 28th is because Mike wants more money.
I thought they were doing it for free for charity.
Nah, money, man. You gotta pay the man. Coming out of retirement, bro. Nah, he sees the opportunity because then he's saying that it's a Thanksgiving weekend.
Uh-huh.
People will be at home to be able to watch it. And I agree.
I mean, I'm going to watch it regardless.
No, that's what everybody says. But Thanksgiving weekend, everybody's at home. This is when essential workers are at home, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, people won't be busy. Shit will be shut down. Everybody's getting ready Friday shopping, all this and that. So, or they've already done that, all that shit. So, they're just at home just trying to chill. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, November 28th. That's when it's look. So look out for that. You know,
Roy Jones, big.
I think
Roy
Mike
Jones.
Said he's coming for it though.
I'm sure he is.
Yeah, that's what he said. He said he's coming for it.
I don't think it's gonna be like, oh no, Lou. I think they're going hard.
And then lastly, we got Khabib and what's the other dude's name? Justin Gaethje. Yeah. So we got Khabib and Justin Gaethje for anybody. You know. Some people don't even like fighting stuff, but
the UFC?
We gotta give it all. We're giving it all right now. It's Khabib and Justin Gaethje, mm-hmm. and it's gonna be a really great fight. For Khabib.
Yeah, for Khabib.
Gonna smother him. Gonna smother the boy. He's not ready for Khabib.
But I don't really like if you're. I guess if you're, I'm the kind of person that stand and fight. I'm not really into that grappling.
I'm all about that stuff. My thing is, if you're great at something, dominate everybody in it. Fuck it.
Yeah, but
yes.
If I was a fighter, that would not be my style. No, of fighting.
That's you.
Yeah, I know. That style of fighting is boring, bro.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. I enjoy the technicality of being so in tune with whatever you're good at and being great.
Two men touching each other like that, the way he smothers. That's
how you thinking about it?
That's why I like boxing over UFC.
If you was outside with that man and you were trying to fight him and he tackled you to the ground, you're gonna be like, yo, bro, stop touching me.
Nah, I would try to get out of that, but you know, yeah, I would try to get out of that situation.
He's like an anaconda is grappling you up.
Yeah, his grappling skills are
going anywhere
out of this world.
Yeah,
but that's not my fighting style. Like, you know, it's
I fuck with it.
I fuck with it.
If you're the best at what you do, dominate everybody else in that shit.
Yeah,
I fuck with that.
Until he meets an elite fighter that he's trying to fight
George St. Pierre afterwards.
What?
Yeah.
That's what the UFC is trying to do. George St. Pierre? Yeah. He's been out of the freaking league for so long.
Yeah. But that's what they were talking about.
That's trash, man. I don't want him to
see George might want that fight because Khabib is undefeated.
And Khabib will beat the shit out of him.
George is what, 26-2?
Yeah, but how old is he?
But they tell him they always say he's the greatest though.
No.
Yeah.
In his division, I take that back. I heard about
What's the dude's name? BJ Penn.
BJ Penn is
son. He's fucking terrible. He's terrible, bro.
What do you mean?
He's in the UFC Hall of Fame, bro. His record is like 16-14.
Yeah.
How?
16.
How?
I don't know. Maybe he was. Did he do something that was impactful? When he was reigning,
because yeah, sometimes they do that. He was one of the ones that were bringing up, like, they brought the name up.
Then
he looks like a chubby little Asian.
Yeah, like I was
looks like the most unathletic fighter ever.
I was watching.
He's Hawaiian though.
I don't mean to be racist, but
if y'all just want to look, just Google BJ Penn. He looks like a chubby, unathletic ass little Asian man. But he could fight though. But he's just not good. He's 16-14 or some shit.
Yeah,
for his career and like two draws maybe, and he's in the Hall of Fame. UFC, get him out of the Hall of Fame. Y'all look crazy.
BJ Penn fought St. Pierre,
and George whooped his ass.
Yeah, but when BJ Penn was coming out, you know, when you come out of the whole tunnel or something, Joe St. Pierre paid a man to dress as a woman to kiss BJ Penn on the cheek.
He's a little
I saw the video. I'm like,
you gotta do shit like that sometimes.
You paid somebody
to get him out of his mind.
He's like, where did he kiss him? Like, yeah, that's when I knew I got him.
Yeah.
Yes. Like, that's,
yeah, brutal. You gotta get him out of his mindset. I fuck with that. do shit like that to your opponent. But yeah, nah, that was just a side note. I just found his life is crazy, bro. You've been arrested mad time than you should.
Oh, BJ Penn?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Right. He's probably got some.
Yeah,
it's all good though. But the Khabib fight,
Khabib's gonna kill him.
Khabib is gonna win.
It's not even gonna be close. But if you enjoy UFC, should watch it. If you enjoy boxing, watch Mike Tyson. Even if you don't like boxing, watch the Mike Tyson fight because that shit's gonna be over in 1 minute and 30 seconds.
I'll watch like Mike Tyson fight over Khabib's fight.
No, you bugging.
Because like I want to see
them both.
I was just two legends, man, coming back.
Knock it off.
Coming back.
Knock it off. Mike is going to take that shit. Like, fucking.
You want to tell me Roy Jones still got it?
Got what?
What do you mean?
He got concussions. That's what he got.
Oh, man. All right.
He still got concussions. Roy Jones got to get caught quick. It's going to be over.
You think so?
Hell yeah.
How old is Mike? Like 52, 53?
Yeah, Mike's like 56.
56? Something like that. Man, I bet you like.
Mike got the hands of a god.
Roy Jones got hands too?
No, Mike will touch you and you'll be going to see God. There's a difference.
Roy Jones, give him that jab. Give him that jab.
Knock it off.
That jab work.
Knock it off.
Let's get it.
All right, let's wrap it up, yo.
That jab work.
We're going to get into our the last segment for y'all. which is going to be our quotables. Going to get into our quotables for the day or for the week.
Yep.
These are quotes that we give y'all, so, you know, y'all could use them as your captions or, you know, anything funny, anything relatable that we find or bring to you guys. So, you know, here we go. You want to start it off?
Yeah. Let me start it off. Like, let me try this out.
I told you it was going to come in handy.
Yeah. The struggle you are in today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow. The struggle you're in today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow.
Yo,
oh man.
I might go with one of these. Oh no, actually, you know what? I'm gonna go with one. Let me think of it. If I can remember it exactly. It's from Future. I ain't gonna go with that one. I don't know if I did this. Alright. I gotta do hit the thing. Alright, this is from Alexander Emelianchenko. He said, no matter how often you put a peasant on the throne, he will remain a peasant. And I will say that again. No matter how many times you put a peasant on the throne, he will always remain a peasant. That's from Alexander Emelianchenko. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. All right. So appreciate you guys rocking with us. That's all we got for you today. Next week, we'll bring you guys the same vibe, you know.
Yeah.
Thank you for hanging with us. We appreciate everything y'all do. For all the people that shared our page, follow us on Instagram. If you're watching this on YouTube, please comment, like,
yes,
subscribe,
hit the like,
you know, hit all that stuff. You know, sooner or later, I'm gonna put all our stuff on the video, but
yep,
you can look in the description. You can find all our pages on there. So, you know, share with your friends, share with your family, share with your moms, you know, your aunts, all that, your grandmothers,
if they want
to listen to us. All of them. Share with everybody you know. You know, we'd appreciate it. It doesn't cost you nothing to share this. So we'd appreciate, you know, just bringing people to us.
Yep.
Just sharing with people, you know, get a good laugh.
Yep.
Even if it's just a clip, show it to your friends, anything like that. And just follow us, you know what I mean? So we really appreciate it. So like, comment, subscribe anywhere. Well, right now we're on Spotify, so listen to us on Spotify.
Yep.
We're on YouTube. We're trying to get on a couple other places. We're on Anchor as well.
Yeah,
our official Brunch Boys on Anchor. So if you have the Anchor app, look us up on Anchor. Listen to us through there or Spotify or YouTube. So again, thank you for vibing with us. We're the official Brunch Boys. Hope you guys have a great week. And, you know, whatever you got in your life right now, make sure you, you know, you love and enjoy it. And then just make sure you don't sustain. Make sure you multiply whatever you got. Keep working at it.
Yep.
So we'll catch you guys next week. We out.
Bottomless mimosas.
Yes, sir. It's the Brunch Boys. We out of here.